Hello students, in this video we will study about the lanthanides and the actinides, F block elements. Several times there was demand for this topic. The topic was quite simple and here I have made the video on this topic. Okay, so lanthanides and actinides are already also known as the inner transition elements, because here the electrons are filled in the N-2th F subshell. So these are deeply embedded, hence it is known as the inner transition elements. The lanthanides are more important as compared to the actinides. So we see the electronic configuration of the lanthanides firstly. Okay, in the lanthanides, all the elements below the lanthanum, the series that have the electrons in the 4F subshell are known as the lanthanides, right? It will have the xenon configuration. It means in the case of lanthanum, it will have xenon configuration plus one electron in the 5d orbital and two electrons in the 6s orbital. Okay, so the lanthanide series starts from the lanthanum having the atomic number 57 to the lutetium having the electronic configuration 71, and it will have the complete fill 4f orbital. It means it will have xenon's structure with 4f14 electrons and 5d1 and 6s2. Okay, so now see, after lanthanum, cerium will have one electron in the 4f orbital and the same configuration all will have. I have not written here, you may see here. Then comes the praseodymium, 4f2, then 4f3, 4f4, 4f5, 4f6, 4f7, gadolinium, then terbium, 4f8, dysprosium, 4f9, holmium, 4f10, erbium, 4f11, then tm, 4f12, ytterbium, 4f13, and lutetium, 4f14. Okay, so here the electrons are filled in the 4f orbital. Now in the case of the actinides, the electrons are filled in the 5f orbital, so we call it 4f series, and to the actinides we call the 5f series. Now what is the difference between the lanthanides and the actinides, 4f series and the 5f series? In the 4f series, the electrons are filled in the 4f orbital. Here both will have the same f orbital. The value of l in both the cases is same, but the value of n is different. In this case, n's value is 4, while in the case of actinides, n's value is 5, right? But there is a basic difference. What? In the case of lanthanide, the electrons are filled in the 4f orbital, and this 4f orbital is deeply embedded inside the, suppose this is an atom, the electrons are deeply embedded inside the atom here. So this is very deeply embedded here, so it does not take part in the bond formation. Because it is so deeply embedded, it cannot take part in the bond formation. So it remains inert like. While in the case of the actinides, the orbital, the electrons fills in the 5f orbital, and 5f orbital slopes are expanded. These are more expanded like this, in this form. So it can interact with the outer atmosphere, right? This is not the shape of the f orbital. I have only made here to get you understand what I want to say here. So the lobes of the f orbitals are expanded beyond the, so it can participate, it can take part in the bond formation with the outer atmosphere or with the outer ligand. So in the case of the 5f series or the actinide series, they have the more tendency to form the bond, to take part in the reactions. And if we see the actinides, the first half of the elements shows are more active toward the reactions, while the later half series will remain inert and they behaves more like the lanthanides, right? Okay, now we see the oxidation states of the lanthanide and actinides. In the case of the lanthanides, the +3 oxidation state is the most common oxidation state. All the elements have the tendency to show the +3 oxidation state. However, some of the elements also show the +2 and the +4 oxidation states. Why they show the +2 or +4 oxidation state? As we know that the, in the case of, if we describe the stability, we can say here that any orbital, if it is empty or it is half filled or it is completely filled, then it will be more stable. So if a element can lose the electrons and it can get the half filled or completely filled or empty orbital, then it will do this. For example, in the case of cerium, here if it lost the 4 electrons, it gets the 4f0 configuration. So it will be more stable. So in the case of cerium, it has the tendency to show plus 4 oxidation state. Similarly, in the case of terbium, if it lost the 4 electrons, then it get 4f7 configuration, half filled shell. It will be more stable. So it has the tendency to show plus 4 oxidation state. In these two cases, plus 4 oxidation state is very common. So here plus 4 oxidation states is shown. Now see, in the case of europium, plus 2. Here it will have 7 configuration. You can see here 4f7. So by losing 2 electrons, it get the 7 electrons here. So very stable configuration. Now in the case of ytterbium, plus 2. Here by losing 2 electrons, it get the 4f14. It means completely filled shell. So it has a tendency to show plus 2 oxidation state are more common in these two elements. Now we know that the plus 3 oxidation states are very common, and all the elements have tendency to revert to the plus 3 oxidation state. So these two elements, if they are in plus 4 oxidation state, they will revert to plus 3. It means they will get reduced. So they work at the oxidizing agents. Similarly, these two elements, if they are in plus 2 oxidation state, they will tend to revert to the plus 3 oxidation state. So they have the tendency to get oxidized. It means they have the good tendency to work as the reducing agent. So these two are good reducing agent and these two are good oxidizing agents. Now we talk about the actinides. In the actinides, we have said earlier that there are two different tendencies. In the first half, they behave more like the transition metals, while the second half, they behave more like the lanthanides. Because in the first half, the elements, the f orbital is expanded beyond and they take part in the reaction. So in this case, multiple oxidation states are shown. So here plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6 and plus 7 oxidation states are shown. While in the second half, they behave like lanthanides and they have the plus 2 and the plus 3 oxidation states common. Okay, now we see the magnetic properties of the lanthanides. We know the magnetic movement of an electron is given due to two factors. We know this is an electron. Electron will have a negative charge. Okay. So first thing is that it is spinning around its own axis. It is spinning like this. So this will give rise to the spin angular momentum. What is this? Spin angular momentum. And another thing is that it is moving in the orbital. It is moving like this. This electron is moving in this orbital. So the rotation of the electron in the orbital will give rise to the orbital angular momentum. Okay. So there are two factors. In the case of the transition metals, we have seen that this orbital momentum is quenched due to the interaction with the ligands. The outer ligands are interacting with this, so this is quenched. So in the case of the transition metals, the magnetic property or the magnetic movement is given by the formula for under root 4s s plus 1. You have studied about this in our previous videos of the transition metal. So here this is given in the case of the first transition series. But if we consult the second or the third transition series, in that cases the orbital momentum is not quenched. So we take both the spin and the orbital angular momentum in the consideration. Similar happens in the case of the lanthanides. In the case of the lanthanides, the electrons are deeply embedded inside the atom. So it cannot interact with the outer ligands, right? So the orbital momentum is not quenched here. So we take both the spin angular momentum and orbital angular momentum in the consideration. And by the interaction of them, we get a new quantum number J. we get a new quantum number j that we call the total angular momentum. And in the case of when the orbital is less than half filled, then j's value is given by l minus s. Okay, when it is less than half filled. And when it is more than half filled, then its value is given by j is equal to l plus s. When it is more than half filled. Okay. Now, the magnetic moment in the case of the lanthanides is given by mu is equal to g under root j, j plus 1. Right? Here j is what? G is the Lende splitting factor. And it is given by g is equal to 3 by 2 plus s, s plus 1 minus l, l plus 1 divided by 2j, j plus 1. So, these are the two formulas by which we can calculate the magnetic moment of the lanthanides. And in general, we know when there are unpaired electrons, then the element will be paramagnetic, and when the electrons are paired, then it will be diamagnetic. So, in the case of La plus 3 and Ce plus 4, in these two cases, there are 4F0 case. It means there is no electron in the F orbital. So, when it is completely empty, then it will be diamagnetic. Okay. And similarly, the two other cases that are of lutetium plus 3 and Yb plus 2. In these two cases, the F shell is completely filled. So, these are also diamagnetic. Rest of the lanthanides are paramagnetic. Now, there is one thing important to concern here. The anomalous behavior of the Eu plus 3 and Sm plus 3. The question on it is several times asked in the exams. Why they show the different behavior? In these two cases, the magnetic moment that we get generally is more than that we calculate. Why this happens? Because in these cases, the gap between two energy levels is very less. This gap is only 300 centimeter inverse. Okay. So, this energy gap is in the age of the thermal agitations. It means at the room temperatures, the electrons can be excited from there to here. The spins can be excited from here to here. It means there may be electrons in this state, higher J values. So, we have to calculate the higher J values also. So, the electrons are here in the higher levels. So, the magnetic moment that is actually is higher than that we calculate. Okay. Okay. Now, we see the spectral properties of the lanthanides. How the spectra of the lanthanides looks like. Actually, in the case of lanthanides, we see the sharp peaks. Sharp and the weak signals we see in the spectra of the lanthanides. While in the case of the transition metals, if we see the spectra of the transition metals, these are broad. And a special characteristic is that in this case, in the case of transition metals, the position of the signals varies with the ligands. While in this case, their position does not depends upon the characteristic of the ligands. It means it will not vary with the ligands. Okay. In the case of lanthanides, all the lanthanides except Lu plus 3, lutetium plus 3, except this, all the lanthanides will absorb in the UV and the visible regions. And the colors of the lanthanides are due to the transition, F to F transitions, forbidden F to F transitions, due to which there are the colors in the lanthanides. Right? Now, we have said earlier that in the case of the lanthanides, there is spin orbital coupling. Spin orbital interaction takes place here. We cannot decide their magnetic properties due to only spin formula. वी शुड टेक इन टू कंसिडरेशन द ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑल्सो. सो द स्पिन ऑर्बिटल इंट्रैक्शन गिव्स राइज टू द जे स्टेट्स. नाउ देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द जे स्टेट्स. सो वी कैन से दैट द जे स्टेट्स, दिस इज ए लोअर जे लेवल एंड दिस इज द अपर जे लेवल. द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस लेवल्स इज कंपेरेटिवली हाई. It means these are far apart. So the energy required for such transitions is more. So in the case of lanthanides, we see the sharp peaks. Okay. While in the case of the transition metals, we see the broad peaks. Another thing is that we know that in the case of lanthanides, the f orbitals, the electrons are present in the f orbital, and f orbital is deeply embedded in the atom. So it cannot interact with the outermost ligands. There is lesser interaction with the outer ligands. So the positions of the signal does not change by changing the ligands. While in the case of transition metals, there is interaction of the d orbital with the ligands. The electrons in the d orbital can interact with the ligand. So the position of these signals can change with ligand to ligand. Okay, so due to their sharp peaks, the lanthanides are generally used for the wavelength calibration. Another important thing is that in the some cases we see broader and stronger peaks, such as in the case of cerium plus 3, terbium plus 3, sm plus 3, europium plus 2 and ytterbium plus 2. In these cases we can see the broader and the stronger peaks. How these peaks arises? Actually in these cases there is a transition from the 4F configuration to the 5D. There is a transition from the F orbital to the D orbital. Such type of transitions are allowed transition. So in this case, the peaks that we see are of high intensity and these are broader. Okay. Another type of spectra, charge transfer spectra, can also be seen in these cases. Like in the case of Ce plus 4, its yellow color is due to charge transfer spectra, while in the case of Sm plus 2, its blood red color is also due to charge transfer spectra. Okay, another important point is the complex formation. In the case of lanthanide, as we have said earlier, we are repeating again and again that the f orbital, f subshell is deeply embedded inside the atom, so it has a little tendency to interact with the outermost ligands, so it have a lesser tendency to form the complexes. Even here in this case the crystal field splitting energy is very less, so the lanthanides have lesser tendency to form the complexes. Moreover, lanthanides behaves like the hard acids and it can form bonds with the fluoride and oxide donors only. Okay, if we talk about the actinides, in the case of actinides, we know that their lobes expands, they can expand because here the electrons are filled in the 5F subshell, okay, that can expand. So the actinides have greater tendency to form the complexes. If we talk of the first half of the actinides, then in that case, they behave more like the transition metals, while in the case of the later half, they behave more like the lanthanides. So this is all about the different points of the lanthanides, different properties of the lanthanides, and I think you should cover all the questions from the question papers. And if you get any problem, you can comment us. In our next video, we will see about the lanthanide contraction and its consequences, and also about the extraction of the lanthanides. Okay, thank you.